Welcome back to Detroit, ladies and gentlemen. This year, it is 2012. It is a presidential election, and the shenanigans have already begun. I don't really understand what's going on with the voter intimidation, so I have Reverend Pastor Charles Williams of the National Action Network here today to explain it to me. Pastor Williams, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
Tell me, what's going on?
Man, there's a whole lot of shady stuff going on, in the words of James Brown. These voter suppression laws that they mask as voter integrity laws are simply meant to disenfranchise the vote in 2012 so that we will not be able to elect maybe candidates that we feel strongly about that may be progressive.
Give me an example of one of these laws.
Well, for instance,
is there anything here in Michigan?
Right here in Michigan, we have voter ID bills. In fact, this week there will be laws voted on. Next week there will be laws voted on by the state legislature that will require you to have an ID if you would even want to register to vote, if you want an absentee ballot, or if you go to the poll and you'd like to vote. If you do not have an ID, your vote will be called a challenged ballot. And we all know what happened in 2000 with challenged ballots. Challenged ballots turned out being ballots that are thrown out.
Okay, so, but so you used to be, when you voted, if you didn't have your ID on you, you could sign an affidavit.
Sign an affidavit and everything's fine, right?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, same thing. You sign an affidavit, everything's fine, except you get a big fat mark on your ballot that says challenged. And what does that mean? Well, some interest group called Citizens for Voter Integrity or Citizens for Fair Elections can come back the next day and go to the Michigan Supreme Court and say, Michigan Supreme Court, can you decide whether you think these ballots need to stay in the election or can you throw them out? And in most cases, if the candidate is not the favorite of the Michigan Supreme Court or one of the courts, those ballots could be thrown out.
So what are you doing about it?
Well, we're organizing right now. We have teams of people across the state of Michigan that are organizing, going to the legislature, talking to our legislators. We have rallies every Saturday. We are trying to mobilize people around that. We went to Selma and marched from Selma to Montgomery earlier this year to put national attention on this issue. And we hope that Governor Snyder will not sign these laws. Mm-hmm. And then we hope that there are clerks that will not implement these laws.
Okay. Are you talking to the Republicans at all? Because
absolutely,
it seems like the Democrats
absolutely
are the minority.
Absolutely.
Why
in fact,
talk to
we,
them?
We've been talking to Peter Lund. We've been talking to Al Pashoka, the same characters who put Public Act 4 together and who passed Public Act 4, the same characters who passed this. And they do it in the name of integrity. But we know that this is all about suppressing the vote. Senator John Papageorge of the state Senate here in Michigan said out of his mouth that the only way that we're going to win a Republican candidate, the only way Michigan will be red is if we suppress the vote in the city of Detroit. And so they're very ardent, they're very clear about what they're trying to do. We're going to just be very clear about what we're trying to do, work against it, and push it. Why? Because of great stories like you have us in today. That benefit from the Small Business Administration and everything that we believe that the administration that's in office currently is doing to help places like
this. So now this doesn't just hurt African American, it hurts
everybody. Why? Because you're voted, if you're a Latino, if you're Arab American, if you're African American, if you're a person who from the bottom, right? At this point, what we see happening in the country is not necessarily a race war, it's class warfare. The folks who are in the middle are getting pushed down to the bottom, and the folks who are in the bottom are getting pushed further down at the bottom. And so we're trying to work, National Action Network, galvanize to bring people up and push people back up.
Now, how do people of all races, creeds, and colors get involved with the National Action Network? You have something every Saturday?
Saturday, 10 a.m., we have an action rally. We want people to get involved, get engaged, get into it, get involved, and get engaged, because we believe that if we begin to organize and mobilize all against all races and colors and creeds, working together and advocating together, then we can win together. But if we are in our own silos, then we will lose.
Okay, how do they contact the National Action Network?
313-312-5287. That's 313-312-5287. And they can always join us 10 a.m. Saturday at the historic King Solomon Baptist Church, 6100 14th Street, Detroit, Michigan.
All right. Pastor Williams, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, and thank you for all you're doing.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. And I'm going to introduce you to Supermarket Higante.